today we're going to be talking a little bit about solids and a little bit about solids, liquids, and gases. Y'all remember last week when you took a little test or thing that wasn't for a grade about solids, liquids, and gases? Yeah? Okay, well today we're going to learn a little bit about what those were and how we can use them in our lives. And so we're going to read a book. Have y'all ever heard of Sid the Science Kid?
Yes.
Okay, well, he's got a really cool book about his melting ice pot. So, can I touch it? Or?
Yeah, it should be able to. You should be able to just pop it.
Okay. Oh no, Sid cries, spotting an orange puddle on the table. My ice pot! I forgot about it, and now it's all melted. Sid asks, why can't ice pops stay frozen? Have you ever wondered why frozen things melt?
Because it gets hot. It gets too hot and it's made of ice.
Yeah.
And ice melts when it gets hot.
I know.
And then when ice comes out of water and anytime it gets hot, it melts.
Yeah.
Fire beats fire and fire beats.
Sid picks up the ice pop stick and hurries downstairs. Look, Mom and Dad, he says. I left my ice pop on the table and it melted. Sid, Mom is not happy. You left an ice pop out overnight, she asks. Sid promises to clean up the melted mess. But then can we make more ice pops, he asks. Dad smiles. Sure, he says. After breakfast, Mom and Dad help Sid make two more ice pops, one for Sid and one for his friend Gabriella, who's visiting after school. Mom puts the ice pops in the freezer. Now, all you have to do is wait, she says. A minute later, Sid opens the freezer door again. Hey, they're not ready yet, he complains. Dad laughs. The juice needs more time to freeze, Sid. Have any of you ever tried to freeze something?
I tried to freeze water with Lego minifigures and it worked.
How long did it take to freeze?
Probably like 4 days.
4 days? Wow.
Yeah. I actually tried
2 days to freeze.
You froze a Lego?
Yeah.
Wow.
It
only Okay, so at school, Sid has a question for his friends. Has a frozen treat ever melted before you could eat it? Yes, an ice cream sandwich, says May. A red, white, and blue ice pop, Gabriella adds. Gerald grins. My bowl of ice cream melted once. It changed into cherry, banana, and chocolate chip soup. Soon, teacher Susie says it's rough time. Sid tells her that he's wondering about why frozen things melt. If you want something to stay frozen, teacher Susie asks, where is the best place to keep it? The freezer, everyone calls out. May turns to Sid. That's why your ice pop melted, she says. It wasn't in the freezer. Teacher Susie explains that as liquids get colder, they freeze. When the ice isn't kept cold, it melts. Sid has a new question. Can you freeze liquid back into ice? Yes, teacher Susie nods. But something can change back and forth. It's called reversible change. Come on, she adds with a big smile. Let's investigate freezing and melting in the super fab lab. Teacher Susie shows everyone a block of ice. Sid is amazed to see fruit frozen inside. That fruit is going to be our snack today, teacher Susie tells them. But Gabriella is confused. How are we going to eat it? Get it? She asks. We can wait for the block of ice to melt into water, says Sid. Then he remembers something important. Oh no. It takes a long time for ice to melt. How long do you think it takes for ice to melt?
Probably
an hour. Everyone thinks of ways to make the ice melt faster. What if we pour something warm on the block of ice? Sid asks. Good idea, Teacher Susie replies. Is there some sort of liquid we could use? Gabriella spots the sink. Warm water, she says. Teacher Susie pours warm water over the block of ice. Now try and get the fruit out, she tells everyone. But the ice is still frozen solid. Teacher Susie pours more water on the ice and then some more. At last, the ice begins to melt and the friends can get their snack. Mmm, Gerald says happily. These grapes are good and cold. On the way home from school, Sid and Gabriella tell Sid's grandma about melting and freezing. Ice can melt into water, and water can freeze into ice, explains Sid. It's called reversible change, the friends say together. When they get to Sid's house, Sid and Gabriella peek nervously into the freezer. Yes, they're finally ready, Sid and Gabriella cheer loudly. Now the friends can have another cool snack, frozen ice pops. See you later, scientist, Sid says. So, what happened to the water?
It froze into ice.
So I would like the last group that arrived to go right back to their desk.
Solid.
solids have a size and shape of their own. These little dots that you see here are little particles. Everything has particles. So in solids, the particles are very close together, and that's what makes them hard, and they're able to remain in shape and intact. So
when it touches the floor, it's
shape of the tall cup, but if your cup is really short, it's the shape of the short cup, right? It all depends on what container you put it in. So if you hold on, if you ever put water in a vase that's curved and the water flows through the curves, that's because it's a liquid. And the particles in a liquid are all spread out. They're not too far apart like gases, but in liquids the particles are just kind of free flowing. And that's what makes it a liquid. It's change shape and size whenever they want to. Gases, its particles are everywhere. You see, they're kind of mixed up, they're different sizes. Careful. They're kind of flowing out of the cup because you can't really contain a gas if it's in an open container, right? A liquid, if you pour it in a cup, it's not just going to jump out of the cup, right? A gas, you can't pour a gas into a cup. It's going to be in the air because who can name me a gas? Anybody have an example? Try your best. Read it. Air. You read that for me? Okay, so earlier we talked about different examples of solids and liquids, and they've got my gases for me, so you can write down a solid on a sticky note for me. Okay, I'm going to give one to you. And one, two. So the blue sticky notes, you're going to write down a solid. Now, for the liquids, who can name a liquid? Oh.
Yes.
We can have three liquids. Okay, so if you have a pink one, go ahead and write a liquid on there. Once you're finished, you can come up and put them on there. Once you write them down, go ahead and stick them in there. While he's thinking, let's see what we've got here. Blue sticky notes. Say a desk and a desk. Okay, I'll put it up. A desk and a desk. What am I talking about? What would a desk be considered? Zoe? What state of matter is a dead skin? Chocolate, that is a good liquid. Yeah. Alright, and so the gases, we have carbon dioxide and air. Who can tell me what carbon dioxide is?
Carbon dioxide.
Who has ever heard of that?
I am.
A couple of you? Okay. Can you tell me what carbon dioxide is? It's air?
I know what it is.
Okay, add on to
it. Questions about what a solid is, a liquid is, or a gas is? Any questions? So, yeah, they're kind of flowing. The particles are a little flowing.
Yeah, and they
Yes, it does mold the shape that it's in. Anybody else want to add anything?
That changes size.
Anyone can help? Yeah. Car? Yeah. So matter is anything that takes up space. So, exactly. Examples of matter are all around us. We are matter. Yes,
chairs.
Chairs. Yes.
The board.
section say draw circles in each box to represent the particles in a solid, liquid, and a gas. Write an example of each state of matter below. So in the box, you can draw a cup or you can use the box as your cup and draw the circles like the particles would be in each state of matter. I'll leave this here so you can reference it if you need to. But I want you to do it for the solid, liquid, and gas. Then below it, you have space to write an example of each. If you have trouble thinking of an example, you can ask one of your friends, or you can come up here and look on the board. We have lots of examples up here, okay? Are there any questions? All right, who's the paper class? Color them. Just make sure you write your examples.
You can